For decades, Mars has ignited humanity's imagination as the ultimate frontier for exploration and colonization. From movies to bold proclamations by tech leaders, the idea of a second home for humanity on the red planet feels almost tangible. But as we dream of sprawling Martian cities and terraformed landscapes, the harsh reality of technological, environmental, and logistical challenges paints a grim picture. Even by 2067, colonizing Mars on a large scale is likely to remain an impossible dream. Here's why. So, you want to build a new home on Mars? Extracting resources from Mars is a monumental challenge. Water exists mostly as ice, requiring significant energy to access. Producing fuel on Mars is another hurdle. We need to synthesize methane from the thin atmosphere. Martian soil lacks essential nutrients for agriculture. The technological hurdles are daunting. It's like trying to build a skyscraper with toothpicks and chewing gum. Here on Earth, we often take energy for granted. We flip a switch and voila, light. But on Mars, energy is a luxury, a precious commodity that will dictate every aspect of survival. Solar power, our go-to renewable source, loses its luster on Mars. The red planet receives less than half the sunlight as Earth, and those infamous Martian dust storms can blanket the solar panels, rendering them useless for weeks. Nuclear power, while more efficient, presents its own set of challenges. Transporting a nuclear reactor across interplanetary space is not for the faint of heart, nor for the light of wallet. And then there's the issue of nuclear waste disposal, a problem we haven't even figured out here on Earth. Other energy sources, like geothermal or wind, are either geographically limited or unreliable in the thin Martian atmosphere. The reality is, we haven't discovered a magical energy source that can power a Martian colony sustainably. Until we do, energy will remain a major constraint on any colonization efforts. Imagine stepping outside without sunscreen, not just on a sunny day, but every single day. That's the reality of life on Mars. Mars lacks a global magnetic field and thick atmosphere, exposing its surface to harmful cosmic radiation. This radiation can damage DNA and increase cancer risk. Shielding is possible, but heavy, expensive, and not foolproof. Habitats need to be buried underground or encased in thick layers of Martian regolith. Living underground can lead to depression and anxiety. We're battling radiation and the psychological impact of confinement. Chapter 4. Dust, an invisible menace. We all know dust is annoying, but on Mars, it's more than just a nuisance. It's a potential health hazard. Martian dust is fine, abrasive, and electrostatically charged, meaning it clings to everything. This dust can infiltrate habitats, clog machinery, and even scratch delicate equipment. But the real danger lies in its chemical composition. Martian dust contains perchlorates, toxic salts that can interfere with thyroid function and pose serious health risks to humans. While we can develop filtration systems and protective gear, completely eliminating the risk of dust exposure is highly unlikely. Imagine living in a constant state of vigilance, meticulously cleaning and decontaminating everything to avoid contact with this insidious dust. Over time, the psychological toll of this constant threat could be significant, adding another layer of stress to the already challenging Martian lifestyle. Chapter 5. Health challenges from low gravity. We humans evolved under the constant pull of Earth's gravity. It's so ingrained in our biology that we rarely consider its impact on our health. But on Mars, where gravity is only about 38% of Earth's, our bodies would face a unique set of challenges. Long-term exposure to low gravity can lead to muscle atrophy, bone density loss, and cardiovascular problems. Astronauts on the International Space Station experience these effects even with rigorous exercise regimens. Now, imagine living your entire life under these conditions. While artificial gravity and advanced exercise equipment could mitigate some of these effects, the long-term consequences of low gravity on human health are still not fully understood. We're essentially conducting a giant experiment with ourselves as the test subjects, and the results could have lasting implications for future generations born on Mars. Chapter 6. Psychological isolation and confined living. Picture yourself living in a cramped apartment, but instead of noisy neighbors, you have the desolate Martian landscape outside your window. Or rather, the lack of a window. That's the reality of life in a Martian habitat, a confined, artificial environment designed to protect you from the harsh conditions outside. The psychological toll of living in such an environment should not be underestimated. The lack of natural light, limited social interaction, and the constant awareness of your isolation from Earth can lead to anxiety, depression, and even more severe mental health issues. We've seen similar effects in researchers stationed in Antarctica, where the isolation, extreme environment, and lack of sunlight can trigger psychological stress. Now, imagine living under those conditions indefinitely, with the added pressure of knowing that help from Earth is hundreds of millions of kilometers away. Chapter 7, Supply Chain Dependency. Imagine running out of coffee on a Monday morning, but instead of a quick trip to the store, you have to wait 2 years for a resupply mission from Earth. That's the reality of supply chain dependency on Mars. Even with advanced three-dimensional printing and resource utilization, certain essential items like specialized electronics, medical supplies, and even spare parts will need to be shipped from Earth. But here's the catch. The journey to Mars is not like a casual road trip. The launch window, when Earth and Mars are optimally aligned for travel, occurs only every 26 months. This means that if something critical breaks, you're not getting a replacement anytime soon. This dependency on Earth for essential supplies creates a fragile lifeline, vulnerable to launch delays, accidents, or even geopolitical tensions on Earth. One disruption in the supply chain could have catastrophic consequences for a Martian colony, highlighting the precarious nature of our reliance on a distant planet. Think Antarctica is chilly? Try spending a winter night on Mars, where temperatures can plummet to minus 140 degrees Celsius. And don't forget those infamous Martian dust storms, which can engulf the entire planet, blanketing the surface in a thick haze for weeks on end. These extreme temperatures and weather conditions pose significant engineering challenges. Habitats need to be designed to withstand the extreme cold and pressure differentials, while also being resistant to dust infiltration. Solar panels need to be robust enough to survive the storms, and rovers need to navigate through the blinding haze. We're essentially trying to build a city in the middle of the most unforgiving desert on Earth, but with even more extreme temperatures and a toxic atmosphere. The engineering challenges are enormous, requiring innovative solutions and a hefty dose of ingenuity to overcome. Imagine a fire breaking out in your home. Here on Earth, you call the fire department and they arrive within minutes. But on Mars, you're on your own. The vast distance between Earth and Mars means that even a distress signal would take several minutes to reach Earth, and a rescue mission would take months, if not years. This delay in communication and response time highlights the critical importance of self-sufficiency and redundancy in any Martian colony. Habitats need to be designed with multiple layers of safety features, from backup life support systems to emergency shelters capable of withstanding catastrophic events. Every system, from power generation to waste management, needs to be meticulously planned and tested to minimize the risk of failure. We're essentially designing a closed-loop ecosystem millions of kilometers away from any outside help. The margin for error is razor thin, and the consequences of failure are dire. Ah, terraforming the holy grail of Mars colonization, the dream of transforming the red planet into a lush, Earth-like paradise. While the idea captures the imagination, the reality is far more complicated, bordering on the realm of science fiction. Terraforming Mars would require releasing massive amounts of greenhouse gases into the atmosphere to trap heat, melting the polar ice caps to release water, and somehow creating a magnetic field to protect the new atmosphere from being stripped away by solar wind. These tasks, while theoretically possible, are beyond our current technological capabilities. We would need to develop technologies capable of manipulating planetary-scale systems, a feat that would require centuries of research and development, not to mention astronomical resources. So, for now, terraforming remains a distant dream, a testament to our boundless imagination, but a stark reminder of the limitations of our current technology. Mars, for the foreseeable future, will remain a cold, dry, and unforgiving world. While humanity's ingenuity and determination are boundless, the technological, environmental, and logistical challenges of colonizing Mars are staggering. By 2067, we may establish temporary research outposts or small-scale bases, but the idea of mass migration or a self-sustaining Martian city remains a fantasy. For now, Mars will remain an awe-inspiring but inhospitable frontier, a testament to the limits of our reach and the resilience required to dream beyond them. If you enjoyed this video, please like, comment, and subscribe for more content.